Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to create the activity diagram for online examination system. So let's get started. So for this I will be using the Star UML software. So after opening that, you need to go to model. In the model you will be having this add diagram, and here you will be having this activity diagram option. Just click on that. So after clicking that, we will be having the necessary shapes and attributes to create our activity diagram. So first we will begin with the initial, okay, and after that we will be having the login, register and authentication activity. So whenever we are logging into any online system by using email, we will be having these things. This is like common for all the systems irrespective of what topic you are doing. So login, register and authentication. So for beginning the activity diagram, we will start with initial. So just go to the top and just click it. So this is initial, and after that we'll be having our action, which is going to be, first action is going to be login, and as I told you, another action. First let me just have the action, then decision box. So here we'll be having a decision box. So sign up, okay. So if the user is already logged in, the user can just log in. But if the user is new, like the student, teacher or someone like that, they can just go to register and create a new account. So I'll just have another action over here, register. Yeah, so once they are having an account, we need to like verify whether the user has entered the right email and right password. So both of them needs to be matching. So for that we will be using the authentication, okay. So this will come after login and register. Yeah, so this is fine. So after authentication we will be having another decision box to check whether the entered credentials are correct, okay. So here we'll be having another decision box. Yeah, so this is fine, I guess. So let me just now have some text so that it makes more clear sense. So for text you'll be having this annotations option. Here we will be having text. So here will be have, I will come here, login. So if the user is not a new user, I just have condition over here, new user. Yeah, so if the user is not a new user, it directly the user can go to authentication. And if the user is a new user, the user will then go to register. So which is yes, new user means register. Yeah, and for authentication we'll be having another condition called as, you can call it validation, maybe validation whether the entered credentials are right, validation. So if the user enters the valid password and email, the user can like further go inside our system, our online examination portal. And if the user enters something invalid, the user needs to, what do you call that? The user need to like, for they again go to login, and the user need to like enter the credentials again. And it just like goes on a loop till the user has entered the right things. So now let me just have some of this fork attribute, because from this point we'll be having multiple flow of the control. Okay, so we'll be having one system for teacher, student and the admin of the portal. So control gets diversified or diverted into many other lines. That's the reason why we will be having this fork. The exact opposite of fork is join. So this is the first thing, guys. So let me just now have a control flow, like draw the lines from each and every point now. So it's going to be to login, and next one is going to be from login to this decision box. And it's not a user, authentication. It's a new user, then register. So after registering, again login, and control flow, then it's going to be authentication. So if it's valid, no problems, you can go into the system. But if it's invalid, the user needs to again go and login. So if it is like overlapping like this, you will just cache this. And so if it's overlapping on register, you can just drag it this way. Yeah, just make it like an rectangle in shape thing. Yeah, this is now well and good. So as I told you, here we'll be having three people using our online examination system. One is going to be the teacher, student and the admin. So we'll be having like three places of like diversification of our line. So here we will be having another action, and here we will be having another action. So first action is going to be for the student. So we will be displaying like three interfaces. In case of an online exam system, we'll be having like different interface for different people based upon their rank and use case. So yeah, so I'll just go here and type student, and next one is going to be for the faculty, or you can just, to keep it simple, you can just have it as teacher. And next one is going to be for the admin, who controls the entire system or owns the entire system, kind of sort of like that. So the student, what can the student do? The student can basically, the main purpose is examination system is take exams, and after taking exam, the students can view results. Yeah, and the student can, like, first thing is see schedules. So just trying to keep it simple. Yeah, so what are the actions that teacher can do? The first action teacher can do is set question paper. And so in case of like the student sends the answers in form of a PDF, the teacher can like download the PDF from the portal and verify it. So grade answers, and the teacher can publish results. And also the teacher can frame syllabus, create the exam schedules, something like that. So you can also like have a separate thing for that, add more and more actions, but I just want to like keep it more simple, so I will just leave it this way. So in case of the admin, I will just go with remove users. So it can be a teacher or a student. The admin can basically remove them in case that particular student or teacher is leaving that institution. So the admin can remove the user completely from that. And apart from that, the admin can also like make, or what do you call that, edit details maybe. Yeah, you can also add this. Yeah, you can also add this edit details over here. In case of the student is going to change their mobile number or email ID, you can also add edit details. It also applies for the teacher also. The admin can also like add details of anyone in case it can be a student or something like that. So I'll just go with add details over here. Yeah, I think that's the function of the admin. Apart from that, the admin can also publish results, set question paper also in case if you give privileges for the admin. So I think this is fine now. So let me just now have the control flow. Yeah, so I will just draw the lines. So if you want, you can just add more actions to it. I think this is well and good. Just keeping it simple now. Yeah. So now we are done. Just, we need to just have a merge attribute, and after that we'll be having a logout. Yeah. So that's it. So after this, as I told you, we need to just merge all these things to a single point. So for that, we'll be using the join. So it's not merge, it's join actually. So I'll just have this join thing over here and just connect everything over here. Yeah. And this is fine for now. And after this, we'll be having the final action, that is going to be logout. And after logout, we'll be having the final, okay? The final, that's it. So we'll just have this circle-like thing, and we'll just have a control flow over here. Yeah. So if you want, you can just add some more attributes, like view old results, like the history of results, and also add an option for the teacher in case, like schedule meetings and stuff, announcement, notice board kind of things for the teacher also. So yeah, you can just expand it whatever the way you want, but this is like the basic template. I think this is well and good. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other UML diagrams, activity diagrams, class diagrams. So you can just check the playlist of my channel and use case diagrams too. Also, I have done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, CRUD operations. So check it out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.